So first was about the assignment statement. In that lecture, Supratik explained that the assignment statement, like A equal to B plus C, is different in a programming language than in maths. It is not an equation. We have seen that even when we discussed an artificial assignment operation done by our character Dumbo. So we know what this means. This particular assignment operation hinges around the equal to symbol. This is not the mathematical equal to. Once again, I repeat, this is an assignment operator. It has two sides, and the statement requires C++ to undertake two tasks. One subtask is to evaluate the expression on the right hand side, which is B plus C in this case. It will take values of location B and C, calculate that expression, get one single result value. It is only then that C++ looks at the left hand side of the equal to symbol. Till then it doesn't care what is there on the left hand side. On the left hand side, it must find a single name, a single variable name to which a value can be assigned. It simply takes the value that it has calculated by evaluating B plus C and assigns that value to A. On the right hand side, the expression that is written could be containing variety of elements and variety of operators. For example, arithmetic expressions will have these symbols. Now these symbols, when you have multiple symbols, obviously they will have to be some precedence and some associativity rule. And wherever you want a precedence to be indicated different from what is implied by the operator, then you can use parenthesis as in any algebraic expression that you use. So anybody who remembers the precedence between these operators? First of all, are you all familiar with these operators? Plus, minus, multiplication, division, and what is this? Modulo remainder. This operator works only with two integer operands. So which of them are higher priority and which of them are lower priority? Last three are higher priority, first two are lower priority. Now, you might mix in the expression elements of different types. So what are the different arithmetic types that you have, numerical types? Integer with its own variations, floating point, float, double, bool. So these are the various types. And there is something called more expressive type to which the less expressive type is converted. For example, floating point can represent larger magnitude of number. So it is considered more expressive than integer. And if you mix two operands, one of integer type, one of floating point type, then the integer type is converted before the operation to the floating point. If both operands are of the same type, the result of any sub-expression is same. If the operands are of a different type, then you follow this rule. But it does this and nothing more. So for example, if I have float A and int B, the float is more expressive than int, and therefore A plus B, A minus B, A star B, A slash B are all float. Why? Because one of them is float, the other is integer. So int will be converted to float. On the other hand, 2 star b will be evaluated as integer because 2 is an integer constant. But if I write this 2 as 2.0, then 2.0 star b will be evaluated as a floating point value. Is that clear? So suppose I have these declarations, double a, float b and int c. Now double is considered more expressive than float. You can reason it out naturally because double has a larger precision as well as larger measurement. And float is more expressive than int. So that is how the conversion will happen. So A plus inside parenthesis B star C will have type double. C is int, but B is float. So B star C will be float. A is double. So A plus anything will be double. So that anything will be converted into double internally while doing this off. So what is this? Just remember the previous line, A is double, B is float, C is int. So this is clearly a completely separate statement which has nothing to do with the declarations that you saw earlier. All right, assume that A, B, C, D are of the same type, or don't worry about the type conversion. But the question is, in what order this expression will be evaluated? Will it be evaluated like this? Yeah, because star has a higher precedence than plus. So star has a higher precedence than plus. So this will be done first. What is A plus B minus C plus D? All are at the same precedence, so the calculations will proceed from left to right, because the associative rule says left to right. So which way will this be done? So it will first calculate A plus B, then calculate the subtraction of C, and then the final result you will add plus D. So left association is the standard association. There are some exceptions that we shall see later. Similarly, star, slash and modulo operator have the same precedence and they are left associated. So please note that this is different from usual algebra, where you don't have a modulo remainder symbol per se, but you normally would not associate with it a high enough priority, whereas in C++ you would. And the best practice is to use parentheses whenever you have any confusion. Then we discuss the logical operators and the logical expressions, and these operate on logical values which either are defined as bool variable values or constants true and false, or they are generated from comparison of numerical values, comparison of logical whatever. And whenever such values are to be operated upon, you use logical expression. So first and foremost, you have these relational operator. So please note, when you want to compare two values being equal or not, you say equal equal. Why? Because a single equal is considered the assignment operator. It is also an operator. Just one equal to symbol is an operator. A equal to 5. So equal to is an operator which assigns the value 5 to A. Curiously, when you conduct an assignment operation, the assignment operation itself has a value, which is the value which is finally assigned to the left hand side variable. So A equal to 5 as a whole expression is considered an expression with equal to operator, and that expression results in the value 5, because 5 was the value which was assigned to A. However, that is treated as an assignment operation, and therefore if you want to check equality, you will do this. This is not equal to, an exclamation mark followed by equal. Again, there are operator precedences and associativities, and use of parentheses is recommended. The value of any logical expression is either true or false. 0 is false. 0 is false and non-zero, any non-zero value will be true. Printing values of logical expression we saw independent of whatever is the non-zero value stored. While if you print and a logical value is true, it will always print 1. That is the stipulation of C++. There are logical operators by which you can combine multiple logical values or logical expressions. So these are two ampersands to represent logical AND. There is binary logical AND. So A greater than equal to B and A greater than equal to. So note, if you want to say that A is greater than B as well as A is greater than C, then only this entire expression will be true. If only one of the sub expressions is true, the other is false, the total value will be false. So you know that simple logic, true and true is true, true and false is false, false and false is false. Exactly the same thing about R. So R is represented by two vertical bars, and you can have this expression as this or this. So again, the truth table for OR is well known. One single exclamation mark is a negation. So NOT of true is false, NOT of false is true. And this logical NOT can be put on the entire expression. So can you tell me when this entire thing will be true and when this entire thing will be false? So this is the precedence. Comparison operators have same precedence, lower than exclamation mark. Then they are left associative. Equal, equal, not equal have same precedence, lower than, less than, left associative. A greater than B, not equal to B less than C is interpreted as A greater than B, not equal to B less than. So please note that this not equal to symbol has a lower precedence than comparison operator. So comparisons will be done first, this and this comparison, and then the two logical values will be combined by NOT. The logical operators NOT, AND OR all of them have precedences lower than the comparison operators, but within them not has the highest precedence, and has a precedence lower than equals, is left associative, and or has a precedence lower than and, it is left associative. So for example, not flag 1 or flag 2 and not flag 3. This is a complex logical expression. This should be interpreted as not of flag 1 or flag 2 and not of flag 3. So you can just apply those rules of precedence and interpret. However, as it was stated earlier, even in the slightest doubt, you just use parenthesis to properly reflect what you have in mind. Next, we discussed in the video the sequential execution of a program. We had again seen that in our plain Dumbo animation as well. The point that is to be remembered is any declaration is not executed at runtime. So just like when I say int something, float something, these are all declarations. We had also seen some funny looking statements like include something using namespace std. These are all declarations. They are read by the compiler. Some action is taken during compilation, but that's it. When the program is to be executed, only executable instructions of your program are executed, and they are executed linear. We use semicolon to separate one executable statement from the next. Consequently, it is possible to write several statements in a single line because they are all uniquely separated by semicolons. The execution is always left to right and top to bottom, as we would read a standard textbook. The simplest programs will represent a linear sequence of instructions, and these instructions are executed in the linear order. So when you use your code blocks, for example, you would have a window on your right hand side. This represents your computer screen, and let's say this is the program. So let us now see how this program is compiled and executed by the C++. You can see a small blob coming there on the left. That is like a thought process. The compiler is not executing anything, but it will notice that you are declaring three variables, A, B, C, all are integer. So it will actually allocate memory. There are no more drawers and a chest and so on, but now you have so many bytes. So an int is how many bytes? 4 bytes. So it will allocate three locations, each of 4 bytes. The next, bool, is a largest. Now there's some kind of a flag variable. We want that to be either true or false. Obviously, if you look at the name, is a largest, we are asking a question to the program. If it is largest, we expect it to be true. If it is not largest, we expect it to be false. That's the intention. As far as compiler is concerned, it doesn't give a damn as to what is the meaning of the name that you give. Name is your choice. Internally, it might choose any numbered location, 1210021, whatever, some location. What will be the length of that location for bool? Technically, a bool has to be either true or false. So one bit is adequate. The bit can be 0 or 1. It so happens that in a real machine, a bit cannot be uniquely addressed. So it all depends upon the addressing mechanism the computer uses. C++ does not stipulate how many bytes should be used for storing a bool. Typically, it could be a 1-byte value. It could be a 4-byte value. It could be any value. But this is also an internal process of compilation. This is a statement which will be executed. So you see a small fellow running. This shows the computer is running to do something. The action will happen here. So the cout statement is an output statement. You have the stream operator here. Less, less means show this out. End L means end of line. So this is where you will see give three numbers. My prompt colon is actually an indication that most of the operating system environments where you will execute your program will give you a prompt where you can give commands. In code blocks, you will not see this prompt, but you will only see a cursor coming there. The cursor, wherever the cursor is, it will show either the next output is going to come there or next input has to be typed by you. The next statement is an input statement. So when this is executed, you have to start giving values. Please note that this statement asks for 3 input values. It is possible to do that. An individual element can be written separately by greater, greater, A, greater, greater, B, etc. Notice that if I give 23 and press enter, the input operation has not ended because the input is waiting for 3 values. And as we showed, the Dumbo will wait eternally till you complete that action. So does C++. So after entering 23, the job is not done. The machine is still waiting for input. Let's say you give two values here, -300 and then 20, then enter. But at this point, the machine figures out that it has the three values. It will take those three values and proceed further. Please note that the values need to be separated by either a blank or a tab or by a new line. So you can give these three values in three different lines by pressing enter, enter after every value, or write all three one after another but with a space. What will happen if you don't give a space between the values? Yeah, if I don't have this space, for example, the value will be treated as 30020, -30020. It can't distinguish without a blank in between the values. Right. Next, it will execute this statement. Nothing appears on the screen, of course, but internally what would happen? So the expression on the right will be evaluated. This is a logical expression. This will result in a truth value, a bool value, true or false, and that will get assigned to is a largest. Notice how this flag is beautifully used in getting my result directly. Is a largest? See out, is a largest? Answer is 1. Why the answer is 1? Because of the three values which are given by me, 23, minus 300 and 20. So this value 23 goes to A, minus 300 goes to B, 20 goes to C. And you can see that among these three values, A is indeed the largest. So when it does these comparisons, it will actually evaluate to true, is largest will be true, and that is what will be printed. Please note that before this, cursor was hanging somewhere here, okay? But when the Dumbo executes this instructions, return 0, there's some discussion on return 0 here. What is being returned? Why it is being returned, why zero is being returned, to whom it is being returned. So please remember the discussion that the entire program is considered as a function. This is the main program. And this function is called by the operating system or your code blocks environment when you execute your program. Later on we'll see that internally you can write other functions which could be invoked. Now whenever you go to that function that does some calculations, it has to return back a value. And that is where the word return is used. Return is a statement, an instruction in C++, which returns a value which you have written. The normal convention when the main program returns to the operating system is to return a 0 to indicate a healthy return. That means the job is done. If something goes wrong, later on we'll see if this, if that, then you want to say, no, sorry, I can't carry on. So you have to say, you will say return -1, return -2. And there are mechanisms by which you can make the operating system analyze what value was returned and take some action outside this program. This is a C++ program here. So include IO stream using namespace std. We had had some discussion on this, but it doesn't matter if you do not completely follow this, because this is just to be taken as minimal required declarations for running a C++ program. This is a comment, and no program should ever be written without appropriate comments. No program, period. It is that important. What does compiler do with the comments? Ignores them. And why the hell do we write them? Because other human beings, including ourselves, are going to read it. Later, when you write a 500 line or a 1000 line C code spread over multiple functions, I will tell you that if the program does not have comments, you yourself, within a month, will not be able to understand what that program does. I can guarantee that after 40 years of experience. Doesn't work. So forget others. For your own sake, you should write comments. In fact, later on when we discuss the software engineering practices, we will see how, when you start writing a program, not a single line of instruction is written unless you have written the full contour of the program in terms of comments. So you first write comments. What you are going to write here, what you are going to write here, what you are going to do next, what you are going to do next. You sort of describe your algorithm by comments first and then insert statements in between so that they are appropriately seen. So this is again a standard int main thing. There are three variables declared, A, B and R. So this is a variable declaration. This statement you already seen, it outputs a string, and NL is another string. This is a standard string which contains what? the new line character. Actually, it is a single character. So you can also represent it by single quote / n single quote. Escape character followed by n is the symbol for that. You take an input of a and b, then you calculate r, which is remainder when a is divided by b. So remainder of a divided by b. Of course, you would not like such stupid comments in your programs later. Here they are written because you are still becoming familiar with what the operators do. Later on, when you know them and you expect all others to know them, you will write your comments which are more meaningful, describing what a segment of a program does rather than an individual. Notice here again, very clean use of a flag. Divides flag equal to r equal equal 0 is the remainder 0. So C++ will flag an error because you have not declared it. What is missing here? So what should I say? Bool divides flag. Just I have said int something something. After this, somewhere here, any place here, but before this statement actually is written, the divides flag should be declared. It is, however, a good practice to declare all variables that you need, bunch them together at the beginning of the program and declare them. That's the best practice both for you and for C++. We are outputting a string, does B divide A, and then I am outputting the flag. If the flag is 0, what do we mean? It doesn't divide. Flag is 1, it means divide. Why? Because R equal equal 0, R will be 0 only if the remainder is 0, which means B divides A, and therefore the divides flag will be 0. If R is anything else, okay, R equal equal 0 will be untrue, and therefore false will be assigned, false will be printed. If I were to find out and print the actual value which is larger amongst these two, what will I have to do? Suppose A is 25, B is 20, and the question was, print the larger value. I have read A and B. We don't know how to do that yet. Please understand that. Because we know that instructions will be executed serially. If I have a C out instruction which outputs A, then A will be output any time, whatever be the value of A and B. If I have a C out instruction B, it will output B, whatever be the values of A and B. And if I put both, it will output both values always. So till now, we do not know how exactly to do that activity. Namely, find out the maximum of the two values and print that value. However, by using sequential execution, we can actually show whether a value is, A divides B or not. I'm digressing. But if I were to compare these two, which is larger, we have seen that larger flag kind of thing. I can print that larger flag to say whether A is the largest or not. But I can't print the largest value so far. All right. So with this, we will now start our questions. So this is the first quiz. Read that quiz and write down your answers. It's a simple quiz. It says identify all incorrect statements from the following which are written. So A, B, C, D, there are four statements written. Many of them or all of them could be incorrect. None of them could be incorrect. You have to read each one, understand what it means and say whether it is right or wrong. First statement says, all variables must be declared before being used. Second statement says, executable statements are executed in sequence from bottom to top. Third statement says, current value of a variable may refer to any previous value stored in the variable. The last statement says, current value of a variable refers only to the latest value stored in it. So out of these statements, which are right and which are wrong? Very quickly. Shouldn't take more than 30 seconds. As you read them, you can figure out is it right or wrong. So everybody has written? Good. So quickly swap your things. This is a simple quiz. We don't want to waste too much time on this. We are going to more important quizzes. So let's go to the next quiz. Which of the following can be used to terminate a sentence in C++? A colon, B semicolon, C comma, D, C++ accepts any smiley as a valid terminate. All of us would like D, but doesn't work that way, unfortunately. C++ is a very stern person like our Dumbo. So, we don't waste time in discussions. All right. Identify the data type of the expression A star B plus C minus D in bracket if A is of type char, B is of type int, and C and D are of type double. All right. Everybody has written? So how many steps you have written? There is one operation, second operation, and third operation. So there should be at least three steps. In the first step, some sub-operation takes place, you will get a value type. Second step, another sub-operation, you will get a value type. Third step, you will get the final value. Everybody has written these three steps? All right. I think that is sufficient because it is a simple question. There are more interesting problems coming up later. The first thing to be evaluated will be, there is a parenthesis here. Parenthesis overrides any priority. So C minus D will be evaluated. C and D are both type double. What will be the type of the result? Double. Now I have A star B plus some result. So A star B plus some result. That result is double, B is int, A is char. So what will be the sub-expression next evaluated? Please note that the order of evaluation of sub-expression is not dependent on the type of individual operands. It is dependent on the operator precedence. Star has a higher precedence than plus. Therefore, A star B will be evaluated first. A is char, B is int. What will be the type of the result? Int. Please remember, char is internally represented as an integer number and is converted to the more expressive type, which is int. So A star B will result in an int. The third operation is the result of A star B, which is an int, plus the result of C minus D, which is double. What will be the result? Double. This is the next quiz. Identify the correct order of preference for the expression A star B slash C plus D minus E star F. No type is given. Is that relevant? Do we need to know what is the type of A, B, C, etc.? No. That's the important point. The type of a value comes into question only when the actual operation is to be carried out, and that too in order to understand what type will get converted to what type of value. But as far as expression evaluation is concerned, it is the precedence and the associativity which decides this. So here I have a question, and the answer to this question is written by writing appropriate number of parentheses. So these parentheses indicate different order, as you can see. This is an individual exercise. Okay, here is one answer. Do you agree with this? Let's independently figure that out. First, which of the operators will be executed? Basically, star, slash, star are the highest priority operators. They have a left associativity. So first, this operation will be done. Then possibly this operation will be done. Then this operation will be done. Next, you have plus and minus, which have the same priority. So first, the plus operation will be done. And then the minus operation. I think that is very straightforward. Just remember one thing. Psychologically, when you write these parentheses, you can see here, this parenthesis is larger than this one. Now, if you have multiple parentheses, by the time you complete, you will have some very large parentheses. Now, when you type them on the machine unfortunately is incapable of typing parentheses of different sizes. They all will be exactly identical size, exactly identical. Just remember this. All right, so which is the right answer? D. Another quiz, find the value of the following expression given that A and C are true and B is false. Select all options that apply. So please look at this slide. But now, I am sure half of you would not have written down that expression on your notebook. All right. So here is an expression. Now I will flash the logical operator precedence. So now you can solve that problem. Solve it and find the logical value of the expression. I'll again draw your attention to this. A and C are true, B is false. This is part of the problem. All right. So this is the precedence. Apply this precedence. logically do those expressions first. This time you can actually keep on getting T or F or 0 or 1, whatever you want to say. And then you can quickly surmise what would be the final value. All right, everybody is done? Now swap your answer books and check your neighbor's answer. If it does not tally with yours, now you can discuss and convince your neighbors. All right, so select all options that apply. Does A apply?
Yes.
Anybody thinks it is not true? Please raise your hand. Everybody thinks it is true. Does B apply? Cannot. If A applies, B cannot apply. At least that much is clear. What about C? Why does it not apply? False. Okay. Does D apply? Why does it apply? How does it become true? So what will be evaluated first? And. Now A is true. And C is? So A and C is true. True or B? B is false. So true or B is true. Therefore this is true. Alright. So this question says, identify all incorrect logical expressions from the following. You don't have to struggle with the values of true and false, but given that A, B, C and D are all Boolean variables, which of these expressions will be considered correct expression by the compiler, and which of these expressions the compiler will say, sorry, this is not a correct expression. Identify all incorrect logical expressions. So write down in your notebook, capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D, out of these, which ones will be considered as incorrect? And write down the answer, in your answer, a brief explanation of why do you think the compiler will think it is incorrect. So there has to be a text line. So you have capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D has four choices. And the way you have to write answer is not by ticking as you do in a competitive exam, but you have to write, say B is incorrect according to you, say you say B, and then write down an English sentence, why do you think it is incorrect? You have to write A, B, C, D, the choices according to you of statements which are incorrect. And for every choice that you make, you have to write one English sentence as to why it is incorrect. Now that may take more than 30 seconds, so do that. Write down why something you feel is incorrect. Done? All right. Now swap your notebooks and comment not only whether the choice mentioned is an incorrect statement, but also the reason for that. Please exchange. Now you have to see your neighbor's notebook and compare things and comment on it. Is there an agreement? Any pair which disagrees either on the choice of incorrect statements and the reason? So let me first ask a question to those who agree. A and C are incorrect. All right. What was the reason given by both of you? Why is A incorrect?
Because of the less than sign. And in the C part, equal to sign.
Less than sign?
Yeah.
Is not correct?
No.
So you can't compare a Boolean value to be less than another value? Absolutely certain. Why is that?
How will we compare that?
You don't think a conversion could occur to an integer value and then comparison be done? No. All right, now let us go to the group which had a disagreement. So first you tell me each of the disagreements and then explain your individual reasons.
I have the option C and he is having option A and C.
A and C are wrong according to him.
Yeah, and I am thinking only C.
And according to you only C. So why do you think A is correct?
Because I don't found any problem in the expression.
So how would it be evaluated?
First, that the AND operation and then the OR.
The AND operation will be evaluated first. B and B. That would be very funny. What is the higher priority? We saw the priority, you forgot to write it down. The comparison operators
So after comparisons,
so we
have compared, then and then.
And this will be ended with B, then.
So if I put the value of C equals to 1, then it is proving to be correct.
So you think that two Boolean variables can be compared with a relational operator, right? Whereas your neighbor thinks that it does not. Okay. Why do you see C is incorrect?
Because it has assignment operation.
Yes.
That's right.
So what is wrong with the assignment operation? I am assigning C to something.
It is in the right. It should be in the left. Assignment operation.
No. The name of the variable to which assignment is to be done is to be on the left. That is the right thing. Okay. Now here is a problem. If the operator, assignment operator, had the highest priority, then this statement would still be correct, because B equal to C would then be assigned first. Whatever be the result would be the value of that expression, and that would be used in the remainder. Fortunately or unfortunately, the assignment operator has a very low priority, and therefore this operation will not be done first. Rather, all these operations will be done first. Now when you do these operations, you will get a value on the left hand side and a variable on the right hand side. Now that is incorrect, because you cannot assign anything to a value. You have to assign it to a name. So on the assignment operation, on the left hand side, there must only be a name, nothing else. If the bracket somehow came around this, B and C, B equal to C, and that got executed first, then it would still be a correct operator. But as we saw the precedences, that the assignment operator has a low precedence, lowest in fact, as compared to all, and therefore it is wrong. All right. Okay, his question was, can I compare a real value with an integer value? Of course, yes. Please remember the conversion that we said will happen even in case of relational expressions. You can even say a float equal 0, but you should never make that comparison, because exact or equal 25, for example. Exact equality with floating point numbers is a very dangerous thing to compare. Floating point values should always be compared as less than equal to, greater than equal to, etc. So I have deliberately not commented on whether A is correct or not correct. Remember, the choice A was incorrect according to them, and they gave this reason. For C, they still could not give any reason. So I have deliberately not answered that question, that whether two Boolean variables can be compared with each other with a relational expression or not. I want you to retain your curiosity, and whenever in your labs you execute programs or you download code blocks on your laptops, and try to give this simple expression and see what happens. Okay. And if you can't, then we'll answer this question later. All right.